Welcome back, fellow scientists. It's Justin again. Today's lesson is all about the rock cycle. So, Mia and I decided to go on a hike so we could... Hold on. Mia? Where'd you go? Mia! Mia, get down from there! What do you mean the rock will stay there forever? We just learned about how rocks are weathered into smaller pieces all the time. I mean, sure, it may take thousands of years, but better safe than sorry. Huh. Mia makes a good point. If rocks are constantly being weathered, how are there any rocks left? By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to describe the different types of rocks and explain how they change through the rock cycle. Let's investigate. We know the Earth is constantly changing due to forces like plate tectonics, volcanoes, and weathering and erosion. And rocks are no exception. Rocks are always changing, even if it takes a really long time. That's because of something called the rock cycle. The rock cycle is the process of rocks being formed, broken down, and transformed into different types of rock over time. Yeah, Mia, types of rocks. There are three main types of rocks: igneous, sedimentary, and metamorphic. What makes each type unique is how it's formed. Take an igneous rock, for example. In Latin, ignis means fire. How do you think an igneous rock might be formed then? If you guessed it has something to do with fire or heat, you're absolutely right. Igneous rocks are formed when rock melts into magma. Then that magma cools and hardens. When magma cools within the Earth, we get rocks like granite. But if magma erupts from a volcano as lava and cools quickly, it creates rocks like pumice or obsidian. So, rocks formed from melting and cooling rock are igneous rocks. Awesome job! I wonder if we can find out how the other rocks are formed just from their names. Sedimentary has the word sediment in it. Sediment is small pieces of rock that have been weathered and eroded. So how do you think sedimentary rock is made if its name refers to rock pieces? They're formed by those pieces coming together. Over time, sediment gets eroded and deposited into layers in places like riverbeds or oceans. The layers pile up, and as more and more sediment stacks on top, the weight presses everything together. This is called compaction, and it turns the sediment into sedimentary rock. So sedimentary rock is formed from sediments being compacted together. The layers building up often make the rocks look like they have stripes, like with sandstone. Because sedimentary rocks form from layers of sediment over time, they're the most likely type of rock to contain fossils, like this ammonite. Great! So igneous rock is made from rock melting and cooling, and sedimentary rock is made from compacting sediments. What about metamorphic rock? Does the word metamorphic sound like any other words you've heard before? When I hear metamorphic, I think of metamorphosis. Like a caterpillar changing into a butterfly, metamorphosis changes things into something new. That's what happens to metamorphic rock too. Metamorphic rocks form when any type of rock, igneous, sedimentary, or even another metamorphic rock, is buried deep underground. Down there, it's super hot, and there's a lot of pressure from the weight of the rocks above. The heat and pressure work together to change the rock's structure, making it something totally new. Unlike igneous rocks, metamorphic rocks don't totally melt. Instead, the heat softens the rock, and the pressure squeezes and stretches it, almost like playing with slime. This squeezing and stretching often leaves metamorphic rocks with bands that look like ribbons, like you can see in this rock. Nice. So now we know how each type of rock is formed. Igneous rock through melting and cooling, sedimentary rock by weathering and compacting, and metamorphic rock through heat and pressure. But just like the Earth, rocks are always changing. One type of rock doesn't stay the same forever. In fact, each type of rock can transform into another through a process called the rock cycle. The rock cycle describes how rocks change over time to become different types of rocks. Take this sedimentary rock, for example. How could it become a metamorphic rock? Well, metamorphic rocks are formed through heat and pressure, so if this sedimentary rock were buried deep underground where there's a lot of those forces, it would transform into a metamorphic rock. So, a sedimentary rock becomes metamorphic through heat and pressure. How could this metamorphic rock become igneous? Think about how an igneous rock is formed, then pause the video and record your thoughts in your guided notes. If the metamorphic rock melts and then cools again, it would become igneous. Now, how could that igneous rock go back to the start and become a sedimentary rock again? We know that sedimentary rocks are formed from weathered pieces of rock, sediments, being compacted together. So for an igneous rock to become a sedimentary rock, it would first have to be weathered by forces like wind and rain. Then, if its pieces are compacted with other sediments, we have a sedimentary rock. And there we have it, the rock cycle. Except, does it always go in this order? Will a sedimentary rock always become metamorphic, then igneous? What do you think, scientists? No, the rock cycle doesn't follow a set path. A rock can transform into any type of rock, depending on what happens to it. A sedimentary rock can melt and cool to become igneous, and an igneous rock can undergo heat and pressure to become metamorphic. And any rock, igneous, metamorphic, or sedimentary, can be weathered and compacted into sedimentary rock again. So the rock cycle doesn't have one set path. Rocks can take many different journeys, changing into new types or even into a new version of themselves, depending on what happens to them. Each rock has its own adventure, shaped by Earth's incredible forces. Let's review everything we've learned today. The three main types of rocks are defined by how they're formed. An igneous rock is formed when rock melts and cools. A sedimentary rock is formed by weathered pieces of rock being compacted together. And a metamorphic rock is formed by heat and pressure within the Earth. The rock cycle describes how rocks can be transformed into different types by undergoing melting and cooling, heat and pressure, or weathering and compacting. To learn more about the rock cycle, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. So, Mia, you wanted to know how we have any rocks left when they're constantly being weathered away. The answer is, rocks aren't disappearing, they're transforming. That big boulder you were climbing could one day be the sand beneath someone's feet, and the rock you skip across the pond could eventually be the peak of a mountain. Through the rock cycle, rocks are constantly being broken down, rebuilt, and reshaped into something new. Keep exploring, scientists. There's always more to discover beneath the surface. See you next time!